Hey guys, so today I'm going to talk to you about how to look good when you're not feeling so hot. Today I actually have a cold and I'm not looking so hot, but I still need to go out, so I'm going to help you with a few tips and tricks to look better even when you are just feeling awful. So first, you need to feel a little better to look a little better. I'm going to make some chicken soup to help myself feel better because we all know that works. And I'm gonna have some tea. Currently I'm using this Tulsi or Holy Basil tea, which has a lot of benefits, but I'm not gonna get into it. I will put a link down there with some more info so you can decide if you might wanna try this too. It's just a very light herbal tea and it gives me a lot of natural energy and I guess clarity. So let's just get to doing our makeup now. Now I'm going to take my Fresh Soy Face Cleanser, and I'm choosing this today because it's super gentle on your skin. It's got a lot of benefits like the amino acid rich soy proteins which help with moisture and elasticity. It also has rose water in it and cucumber which is really calming to your skin. Now I'm going to take one of my all-time favorite products. This is the Clarins Beauty Flash Balm, and it's just a super moisturizing product that kind of creates a barrier between your skin and the outside world, especially if you need that extra pick-me-up when you're not getting enough sleep, you're coughing, and you're dehydrated. It works wonders for your skin. Now I'm going to grab my Bobbi Brown Hydrating Eye Cream, and I really like this because makeup applies really nicely and smoothly on top of it, but any eye cream will do. Just make sure to hydrate underneath your eyes since this is the first place to show signs of dehydration in a lot of people. Now I'm going to grab my Laura Mercier Hydrating Primer because I need a little extra moisture and a little extra longevity in my makeup for the day. Now I'm going to take my Dr. Jart Premium BB Cream and I'm going to mix it with my Fresh High Noon Glow, which is a kind of bronze moisture product, and I'm doing this because I'm just trying to find any way to add a bit of life and color to my skin. Here I'm going to take a little bit more of my BB Cream and put it underneath my eyes in a kind of triangle-like pattern. And I'm going to put a bit on top of my lids and then also underneath my dry and red sad nose. Now I'm using my Bare Minerals Stroke of Light Eye Brightener, and this is great because it diffuses light underneath your eyes, which eliminates the appearance of shadows or any kind of darkness you have under there. This is an awesome product and one of my absolute favorites right now. Now I'm going to be brightening my eyes further with the NYX Wonder Pencil and a NARS eyeliner in the color Rue Bonaparte, which is just a kind of beige brightening color. I'm going to start at the inner corners of my eyes and kind of work out. And then I'm going to line underneath my bottom lashes to make my eyes look even bigger and brighter and more awake. Now I'm going to take the NYX Wonder Pencil and put it on my lower waterline. Next, I'm taking my Terracotta Light Bronzing Powder. I love this because it has a bunch of different shades that blend together really nicely. It's got some pink tones and some light bronze colors, which all together look really believable on your skin, especially if you have pale skin like me. If you don't, they have a lot of other shades that will definitely do the trick for you. Now I'm taking this convertible color from Stila in the color Lilium. It's just a really soft medium pink. And I'm gonna put it on the apples of my cheeks because that little bit of color will make you look a lot healthier and a lot less sick. Now I'm going to take Girl Meets Pearl from Benefit, which is a really lovely luminizer. It also has moisturizers in it, like sesame seed oil and raspberry, and also chamomile, which is super soothing to your skin. I like to just put this all over my cheekbones and underneath my eyes for a nice, highlighted, moisturized glow. Now I'm just going to take my favorite mascara, which is the Maybelline Falsies Mascara. I like to use the color brownish black because I'm obviously kind of pale and I think it looks more natural. So I'm just going to focus on keeping this really light and kind of just opening up my eyes further with this. I don't want it to be super heavy just because my eyes are really watery and I just don't want to be dealing with that all day. Now I'm just going to grab my newest eyeshadow, which is MAC Satin Taupe. It's just a really nice kind of shimmery medium brown that isn't too harsh and again won't run everywhere if my eyes tear up. So I'm just going to put this starting at the centers of my lids and kind of messily work out, just because it can't be too precise today. I just want to define my eyes a little bit. Now I'm just going to grab Benefit's Posy Tint, and it's just a really nice bright pink stain that stays on your lips even through some wear and tear, aka blowing your nose and stuff. So that's really perfect for this look, and I'm just going to put this on before I put my lip gloss on. Next, I'm going to use some of my Anastasia Brow Gel just to kind of brush my eyebrows out and make them look a little neater. Now I'm grabbing the L'Oreal Color Caress Wet Shine Stain Lip Gloss, and I love this because it really stays on and it's just a beautiful pink color. This is called Rose On and On, or number 184. I like to focus it on the centers of my lips because I think that's just a more believable flush, even though this obviously isn't my real lip color. This look is all about looking fresh and healthy. Now I'm going to take some Fix Plus from MAC just to set it all in so it holds up against the nose blowing and the eye watering. Also, I just think this gives a really nice finish to your makeup. Now, since I don't really want to do anything to my hair but I still want to look presentable, I'm going to just do a side braid here. Something I like to do if I'm doing a really casual side braid is put a cute hair tie in the bottom of it, just because I think it jazzes it up a little and makes it look like you tried a little bit harder than you did. Okay guys, that is all for this How to Look Good When You're Not Feeling Good video. I hope that helped a little. All the info for this will be down in the description bar, and thanks so much for watching guys. Bye!